Hello student, welcome to your chemistry lab. Today I am discussing chemical bonding. Here I will be discussing sixth part of chemical bonding, that is hydrogen bonding and molecular orbital theory. It is last part of chemical bonding. It is important for JEE and NEET and also board. So read very carefully. So now watching the whiteboard. Hydrogen bonding. Hydrogen atoms is in bond with highly electronegative atoms like fluorine, oxygen, nitrogen. The hydrogen atom carries partially positive charge, while the more electronegative atom like fluorine, oxygen or nitrogen carries the negative charge due to difference in electronegativities. If hydrogen atom carrying partially positive charge come closer to the more electronegative atom like fluorine, oxygen or nitrogen of another molecule of same compound or different compound, there exist some weak electrostatic attraction between positive charged hydrogen and negatively charged more electronegative atom like fluorine, oxygen or nitrogen. This weak electrostatic attractive force which binds hydrogen atom of one molecule with more electronegative atom fluorine, oxygen or nitrogen of another molecule is known as hydrogen bond. Types of hydrogen bonds. Hydrogen bonds are two types. One, intermolecular hydrogen bond and two, intramolecular hydrogen bond. First, we are discuss intermolecular hydrogen bond. Intermolecular hydrogen bond is formed between two different molecule of the same or different substance. For example, hydrogen bond between the molecule of HF, H2O or between H2O and alcohol. Second one, intramolecular hydrogen bond. Intramolecular hydrogen bond is formed between the hydrogen bond and the highly electronegative atom fluorine, oxygen or nitrogen present in the same molecule. Intramolecular hydrogen bond result in the chelation of the molecules. For example, the intramolecular hydrogen bond in orthonitrophenol and orthonitrobenzoic acid can be shown as follows. Influence of hydrogen bonding on the properties. Hydrogen bonding has important effect on many physical properties such as melting point, boiling point, solubility, etc. of the compounds. First point, physical state. Hydrogen bonding influences the physical state of the substance, solid, liquid or gas. For example, water is liquid while H2S is a gas. In water, oxygen is highly electronegative so that it forms hydrogen bonds. As a result, the molecule of H2O get associated with one another so that water exists as a liquid. On the other hand, the electronegativity difference of the atoms in H2S is almost negligible. As a result, H2S is not associated and exists as a gas at room temperature. Similarly, the existence of ethanol as a liquid and C3H8, that is propane, as a gas at room temperature can be explained. Point 2. Melting point and boiling point. The compounds containing hydrogen bonds have high melting point and boiling point. It is due to the hydrogen bonding, the electrostatic attractive force in the molecules becomes large. Consequently, larger energy is required to separate those molecules before they can melt or boil. The melting point and boiling point of the hydrides of group 14, 15, 16 and 17. The melting point and boiling point increases as the molar mass, that is molecular mass, increases in group 14. This is due to the fact the size of the element of group 14 increases. The number of electrons also increases. As a result, van der Waals force also increases and therefore melting point and boiling points increases. However, hydrides of group 15, 16 and 17 do not show this trend. In this group, the melting point and boiling point also increases with increase the molecular mass, with the exception of the first member. The first member NH3, that is group 15, H2O group 16 and HF group 17 have abnormally high melting point and boiling point. The high melting point and boiling point of the first member of each group is due to the intermolecular hydrogen bonding shown by this compound.